Assalamu alaikum, my dear students. Today we are starting our grammar work, and it's the first formal grammar lecture. This lecture is not just for one class, because the general concepts of grammar are related to all the classes, especially the board classes. As I am teaching 10th class and second year, mainly the students of these two classes may take advantage of this lecture. However, the students of other classes may also consult these lectures. So first of all, we are going to have a look on parts of speech. Now, parts of speech is a common term, and especially those students who have already gone through their 9th class or first year class know what parts of speech mean. Parts of speech are classes of word classes. All words in the English language are divided into different classes, different groups. So, in parts of speech, we discuss and describe words, classes, and their different groups. So, as you can see on this slide, a very simple definition of parts of speech is given there. All words belong to different word groups or word classes known as parts of speech, based on the part they play in a sentence. Now, it's a very important point to keep in mind. A word in its individual form, in its separate form, may not be properly described as having relation to one part of speech or the other one. It is basically in a sentence that we come to know whether that particular word belongs to one part of speech or the other. So it is the function of the word, of the given word in a sentence, that tells us what part of speech it belongs to. According to grammarians are experts of grammar, authorities on grammar. There are 8 such classes. So, normally, traditionally, we divide all English words into 8 parts of speech. And those 8 parts have got their names. The first one is noun. The second one is pronoun. The third one, adjective. Then verb, adverb, preposition, conjunction, and exclamation. So these are 8 parts of speech or 8 word classes. Now, first of all, we'll discuss noun in detail. Noun. A noun is a part of speech that names an object. That's very simple. Any name is a noun. A noun is a word that is used as the name of an object, anything. Now, nouns can name. What type of names are there? Now, nouns are the words that name, number one, things. Now, just to look around yourself, and you'll see a number of things there in your room. All those things have got their names. Everything has its specific name. all those names are nouns. I have given only 4 examples here, but you may add a number of things there. Car, book, chair, egg, curtain, table, book, cupboard, floor, fan. There are many things. Then nouns may denote the names of living creatures. All living creatures have also got their names. I have given 4 examples here. Cat. There are many cats. Human. There are human beings. Horse, lion, other living creatures. For example, butterfly. For example, glowworm. Dog. Donkey. So there are so many living creatures, and their names are also nouns. Then the names of places are also nouns. Mountain, village, Islamabad, Pakistan, other countries, other cities, other places, school, college, academy, all these are names of places, hospitals, office, these are names of places. Then there are materials. There are different materials we use to make different things. So the names of those materials are also nouns. Gold, iron, silver, cloth, water, paper, milk, all these are materials. So their names are also nouns. Then names of processes. We keep ourselves engaged in different processes. Different processes are going on around us. So all those processes are all those processes also have their names, and their names are also nouns. Life is a process. It starts and it has an end. Laughter, game, solution, there are many other processes. Smile, anger, all these are processes. Excitement. Now, all these names may be put under the head of processes, and they are nouns. Similarly, state, our condition, different states and conditions have also got their names. Rest is a state, sleep is another state, health is another state, happiness is further state. So these states also are nouns. Then there are abstract concepts. Concepts that may be described, that may be discussed, but we can't perceive them through our 5 senses. Those concepts are can't be touched or seen. Masan, beauty. Beauty is an abstract concept. Whatever we see is a beautiful thing, a beautiful person. But beauty itself is an abstract concept. Evil, truth, justice, honesty, all these are abstract concepts. Then qualities. Qualities have also got their names. Kindness is a quality, mercifulness is another quality, courage, innocence, freshness, cruelty, these are qualities. Now these qualities have also got their names. So all these names, whether they are names of things, living creatures, places, materials, processes, state, abstract concepts, qualities, all these names are nouns. Now, let's look at nouns, how they are made, how they are derived. Now, nouns may be simple, derived, or compound. There may be 3 categories or 3 groups of nouns. Nouns may be simple. simple nouns consist of one root. They are single words. They have only one root. For example, home, dog, sky. They are simple nouns. They are not made with the help of other nouns or other words. They are complete words. They are simple roots. Then there are derived nouns. Derived nouns are nouns which are made, which are formed using some prefixes or suffixes. They consist of a root, they have a root, and one or more prefixes or suffixes. For example, friendship. Now, in friendship, you can see that friend is the root and ship is a prefix. Richness. Rich is the root and ness is I have made a mistake there. Friendship. Friendship, in friendship, friend is the root and ship is the suffix. Richness. Rich is the root and ness is the suffix. Teacher. Teach is the root and er is a suffix. So suffixes such as ant, ent, dom, er, or, ar, hood, ion, ity, meant, ness, ship are typical for nouns. Such suffixes are typically used to make nouns. Compound nouns are there then, which are actually made using two nouns. They consist of at least two roots. They have two roots and they are made using those two nouns or two roots. Seaman, you may see that sea is a noun, man is another noun, and by using these two, we have made a new name, a new noun. Editor-in-chief, editor is a noun, chief is another noun, in is a preposition, and using these three words, we have made a compound noun. Independence Day, independence is a noun, day is another noun, using these two names, or two nouns, we have made a compound noun. Then, classification of nouns in English. English nouns are further divided under different heads. Those heads are not always mutually exclusive, which means that nouns described under a specific head may also be described under another head because there are certain characteristics which are shared. So nouns are divided into proper and common nouns. First of all, we divide these nouns into proper and common nouns. Proper nouns represent, they stand for, they show usually geographical names, nationalities and languages. They show the names of areas, different areas of the world, for example, Africa, Pakistan. Now these are geographical names. Nationalities, Pakistani, Chinese, Iranian, these are nationalities, and names of languages, Urdu, English, Persian, these are also nouns and they are proper nouns. Then personal names, individual names are also proper nouns. Every person has got his own name. Parvez, Saleem, Ali, Akhtar, these are different names. These are personal names, they are proper nouns. Then names of months and days of the week are also proper nouns. Monday, August, these are proper nouns. Names of celestial bodies. Celestial bodies are heavenly bodies. Whatever we see in the sky, the names of those bodies, the sun, the moon, similarly other the Mars, the Jupiter, these are celestial bodies. Names of shapes, hotels, clubs, they are also proper name, the Santa Maria. Santa Maria is the name of a ship that Columbus used during his exploration, the Santa Maria. The Marriott is the name of a hotel. So these are proper nouns. These are proper nouns. Then holiday names, names of different festivals, names of different celebrations, Eid Milad-un-Nabi or Christmas, these are holiday names, they are proper nouns. Names of buildings, streets, parks and bridges, Hyde Park, the Centaurus Mall, these are proper nouns. Names of institutions, organizations, media are also proper nouns. North Atlantic Treaty Organization, NATO, the Pakistan Times is the name of a newspaper. So these are proper nouns. Now, and a very important thing to keep in mind, to remember, is that proper names are capitalized. Whenever you use a proper name in a sentence, you use capital letter to start that name. If this is a combination of several words, all of them except articles and prepositions are also written with a capital letter. If there are compound words, for example, there are several words in a noun, you may use capital letters to denote all the important words there, except leaving out articles and prepositions. For example, the United States of America. You can see T of the is not capitalized, but United, U is capitalized, States, S is capitalized, O of is not capitalized because it's a preposition, but America, A is capitalized. So that is the way we capitalize proper nouns. Then there are common nouns. Common nouns is the general name used to describe all the members of a group. The names that may be used to describe all the members of a group. For example, boy, all the boys are boys. Girl, all girls are girls. Table, all furniture items of a specific type are called table. Town, there are different towns in the world. City, there are many cities in the world. So these are common nouns. Common nouns are divided into countable and uncountable. Common noun may be countable or uncountable. Countable are the nouns which can be counted and have the plural form. These two things are to be kept in mind. Which can be counted, which are countable, and also have the plural form. Now, in the English language, there are certain nouns which in other languages may be counted, but not in English. That's why they are still uncountable. Countable nouns are only those nouns which are counted and they have plural form in the English language. For example, chair, we say one chair, but when we talk of chairs, we say, for example, seven chairs. So chair has a plural form, it may be counted. Similarly, child, one child or three children, child is singular and children is plural. But there are uncountable nouns which can't be counted and do not have the plural form in the English language. Iron as a material, as a matter, iron is uncountable. Furniture as a whole is uncountable. When we talk of different items of furniture, we'll have to use the word item. We can't say furniture because furniture doesn't have the plural form in the English language. Similarly, information is also an uncountable noun. it doesn't have the plural form information. Information will be wrong. So that's the end of today's lecture. Thank you very much. We have gone through just the first part of your grammar, general grammar. Inshallah, in our next lecture, we'll be covering some more parts of grammar. Thank you very much.